2010. It got sold, and in 2011 it was issued, the tender was handed, and then supply was in 2012. When the products came in, people started complaining. Well, those in the system heard new noises about it, but it wasn't until FDB in April issued an advert that there were substandard condoms and people should be careful about using substandard condoms because they had holes in them, they broke during action. Then the ministry said, no, we're this kind of woman. Let's have a committee to investigate. It's taken us 7 months, but we've 6 months, but we've done a thorough job. At the end of the day, the fact of the matter is that over 128 million substandard condoms were procured. 80 million were distributed before this thing was picked up. In view of that, obviously, there's a serious problem. If 80 million people have condoms which are not of the quality, there's a problem here. The minister has investigated. We realize that across board there are problems from all the agencies. So from the point of entry in the ports to the Central Medical Source to the Food and Drugs Authority, everywhere there are issues which must be looked at. We have made recommendations and we hope the ministry would implement those recommendations. Finally, we've also said that we must ensure that we follow not just the letter but the spirit of the Public Procurement Act to ensure that we get value for money in our procurement.
But there wasn't any mention of punishment, punitive measures.
We have recommended strongly that, one, the company should refund the full amount of money. Two, that the ministry should discuss with the Attorney General's office if a crime has been committed, and if one has been committed, to do what the Attorney General and the police do best. Our job was to investigate. We have found a lot of inconsistencies, a lot of errors, a lot of inappropriate actions, a lot of unprofessional behavior. None of these are acceptable. I mean, you look at it, you have a country of 20 million people. You buy 128 million condoms, and those tested, almost all, were substandard.
But it's also surprising that even the country of origin is not known. What? And you are not able to establish that.
Put it this way, we have been told a country where it came from. That country has checked and said no, less than 17% of the products came from that country. So that means that there is a problem. And as far as we are concerned, if you don't know the origin, the country of origin of a product, you don't have a product. But if the product is grossly deformed, so that you don't even need a laboratory test to know that it's fake or substandard or not fit for use, then there's a bigger problem. But I think the essential thing is this: why would we subject our people to such danger? Why would we do this? I mean, it beats my mind. Because at the end of the day, health products, medical products, should have some standards. And any gross abuse of that or any system which doesn't ensure that the standards are maintained is in trouble.
Finally, we have